Our story today is about a settlement called Jamestown. It is the first permanent English settlement on the North American continent, and it's named after our gracious king, King James I. The journey was undertaken by three ships, the Susan Constant, the Godspeed, and the Discovery on December 6, 1606. The first president was to be Edward Maria Winfield, and the councilor members were Bartholomew Gosnold, Christopher Newport, John Martin, John Ratcliffe, George Kendall, and John Smith. On June 22nd, Captain Newport left for supplies, but when he got back, disaster had struck. Now, to give you a visual representation of the journey, we're going to pass you over to Melinda Mayo.
Thank you, John. The colonists came from over here, around Britain, all the way over to little America. Budget cuts.
Well, I think it's time for a commercial break. This trailer is actually for a movie about the first murder in Jamestown.
You know, there's something about a tangle of strangers pressed together for years, with only one thing in common: survival of the starving time. This murder will not go unpunished. I know who did this.
Where is he?
Swear, the rash is getting worse.
You need to go see a doctor.
Oh, we're live. Back to our story. Jamestown was picked to settle for many different reasons. The most important reason is that it followed the criteria of the Virginia Company, the funder for the settlement. Jamestown is surrounded by water on three sides, allowing for easy access by ships, and it adds natural defenses against any Spanish attacks. It was a near perfect place to settle. On June 15th, the settlers completed their fort. It could hold four or five pieces of artillery per bulwark, and being a triangle fort, it had three bulwarks. The fort protected the settlers from the Spanish and the local Powhatan Indians, who could have been hostile towards the colonists for building on their hunting land. However, the fort may have given the settlers a false sense of security based on what happened next. Now, I believe we actually have someone special here. We've arranged for an interview with Christopher Newport. Let's go over that. Take it away, McLean.
Thank you, John. All right, Captain Newport, can you tell us about your experiences at Jamestown? Captain Newport.
What? No! They killed them all!
Well, I believe Captain Newport is not in his right mind. When he arrived back, he saw the entire settlement in shambles. Palisades were in shambles, and the gates were off their hinges. After Captain Newport had left, the settlers had begun succumbing to disease. The water supply was also contaminated. Salt and slime were in the river they drank from, causing many people's early deaths. Famine was also rampant within the settlement, but Chief Powhatan sent the settlers gifts of food to keep them from being wiped out. By late 1609, however, the settlers demanded too much food during a drought, souring relations with the Powhatan Indians. During the winter of 1609 to 1610, the settlers were afraid to leave their fort as they were worried that the Powhatan Indians would kill them, and rightly so. When they ran out of food, they ate anything they could. Animals, leather from their shoes and belts, and even other settlers were consumed. According to William Strachey, by early 1610, 80-90% of the settlers had died of starvation and disease. Jamestown today has been revitalized, and it is a profitable settlement. We actually have a reporter on the scene. Let's get a first-hand look at Jamestown from Chris McLean.
Thank you, John. As you can see, Jamestown is now doing better than ever. John Wolfe helped turn Jamestown into a profitable settlement by introducing a new strain of tobacco. His wife, Pocahontas, sadly died this March. Let's get an interview with one of the settlers. Sir.
Yes, I'm sir. What you need?
What do you do here in Jamestown?
I kind of just randomly walk off with a gun. People kind of think I'm a guard, so, you know. I figured that if there's more men than women, and if there's more women than men, then someone would have to marry me.
How's that working out for you?
It's not doing very well.
Back to you, John.
Wow. Such great things happening there. In the future, Jamestown is rumored to be getting slaves to work on the tobacco fields, as well as a general assembly. We can't wait to see what happens to this budding colony. I think that's all the time we have left today. Tune in tomorrow for more Greater England news. I've been your host, John Bray.
Thank you, John. As you can see behind me, Jamestown is doing better than ever. John, how do I pronounce that word? John Wolfe helped turn Jamestown into a profitable settlement by introducing a new strain of tobacco.
Did you drop your script?
I just broke my script. Sir.
Yeah?
Yes,
I'm sir. What you need?
What do you do here in Jamestown?
I really don't do much. Look at those helicopters. I kind of just like wander around with a gun. People think, you know, I'm kind of a guard, but I just figured that, you know, if there's less men than women, then someone would have to marry me.
How's that working out for you?
It's not doing good.
Back to you, John. Very cool, Kanye, very cool.
You said too.
I got you. I'll fix it, I'm sorry. John Wolfe helped introduce a new strain of tobacco, which caused Jamestown... Never mind, just start that over. John Wolfe.
Where's my f***ing whiskey? Wanna beat you up?
I guess.
Where is he?
No, are you?
This shit.
Oh yeah, that was good. I gotta do Brewster.
I think I'm good
Brewster. Yeah, I see.
Let me see how.
Autism. That can't go on bloopers. You yelled the word.
He can edit it. He can edit it.
Yeah, I could jump this.
No. Freaking crackhead. He didn't even do it.
You said I have another part.
No, I said stuff I shouldn't have said.
More.
Oh, yeah!
I said start crying.
I can't cry. Oh, God. I can't cry. Come
fake
on.
It! Fake it!
I don't know. Oh.
What's that on?
What the hell? Looks like you're brawling. Chris, come on, Chris.
Pick it up.
Okay, Chris.
Oh, he can do it.
Okay, Chris.
Oh!
Okay, Chris.
Oh!
Does anyone else not have a dying urge to go spank that horse? Oh, God, you got No. Please, God, no. Delete that. Ow. I'm going to kick that camera out of your hands.
Ow. Ow! Stop!
Oh my God, it's the horse's butt! I don't have a... I said it's over, you...
And what?
No, please delete that.